Hi, I'm Stefan, and I'm a security research engineer at pentesttools.com. Since January 2024, we've been working on a comprehensive benchmark of the most popular web application vulnerability scanners. I'd like to give you a quick background on why we did this benchmark, what results we got, and how we can validate it independently. There's also a white paper you can download from the description below, which includes access to all the results behind this benchmark. We created this benchmark to address a common challenge in web security: comparing vulnerability scanners effectively and as objectively as possible. As a community, we don't really have any standard benchmarks, and the information from vendors can be limited. For instance, one of the few extensive benchmarks dates from 2017, when Shay Chen evaluated 10 web application vulnerability scanners and published the results after a 2-year-long effort. With this benchmark, we wanted to provide a clear, unbiased comparison to help security people avoid spending time and energy they can't spare on figuring out which tools can actually help them. Of course, we didn't ignore the greatest obstacle of all, the inherent discrepancy between control benchmarks and their real-world applicability. Despite meticulous design and rigorous execution, the outcomes from real-world deployment are likely to differ from those we got in a controlled setting. To ensure a fair and comprehensive benchmark, we tested 6 well-known web application vulnerability scanners: Acunetix, Burp Scanner, the pentesttools.com website vulnerability scanner, Qualys, Rapid7 InsightVM, and Zap. The choice of scanners also reflects the tool mix that most security teams use. We used 2 test environments: Broken Crystals and the damn vulnerable web application. We chose Broken Crystals for its use of modern technologies and diverse vulnerabilities, including REST and GraphQL APIs. And we picked DVWA because it reflects many real-world scenarios with its range of classic vulnerabilities. We manually configured each scanner to use their most comprehensive crawling strategy and to attempt to use all the vulnerability detections they have. Some vulnerabilities popped up in endpoints protected by authentication, so where possible, we configured each scanner to run the scan as an authenticated user. To guarantee a uniform and impartial evaluation, the analysis focused on 3 performance indicators: true positive count, false positive count, and false negative count. You can find out how we defined and measured these from the white paper you can download using the link in the description. In February 2024, we deployed both Broken Crystals and DVWA to a VPS in the cloud. This deployment provided an unbiased, replicable, and streamlined playground to test all the selected scanners. We scanned each of the vulnerable applications with each tool included in the benchmark. Once a scanner finished, we reset the target web application to its initial state to ensure the scanners don't interfere with each other. Using the default settings, we would have made it easier for independent reviewers to validate the findings in this benchmark. But this would have excluded many vulnerability detection modules, making the results inaccurate. However, you can still validate the results independently. It just takes a bit more work. Let's get into them. Acunetix leads the pack when it comes to detecting vulnerabilities in Broken Crystals. The pentesttools.com website vulnerability scanner and Burp are tied for 2nd place, while Zap outperformed both Qualys and Rapid7 InsightVM. In the DVWA tests, Burp led with 29 out of 39 vulnerabilities detected. The pentesttools.com website vulnerability scanner came in 2nd, followed by Rapid7 InsightVM and Acunetix. Zap, however, reported a significantly higher rate of false positive, especially when detecting SQL injection vulnerabilities, which impacted its overall ranking. While all scanners showed good detection capabilities, the rate of false positives varied quite a lot. For example, the pentesttools.com website vulnerability scanner had a notably lower rate of false positives. In contrast, Zap's higher false positive rate in DVWA scans highlighted areas for improvement. When interpreting this performance data, it's crucial to acknowledge that exemplary results in benchmark testing don't always translate directly to real-world scenarios. Similar features differ in implementation across web applications frequently, which results in corner case scenarios and complex flows. These nuances, which no benchmark can fully cover, can affect the performance of scanners when deployed in actual environments. Ready to dive deeper into the details and see how each tool stacks up? Download the full white paper for the data breakdown. The link is in the description below. Until next time, stay safe.